Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, consider subscribing. Today I'll be showing you how I build this NFT hydroponic system using 2-inch PVC pipe.
I did use leftover pipe from my previous 3 hydroponic system builds. That's why it may look a bit dingy. This hydroponic tower is fairly simple to build using handheld tools. So stick around to see how it was done. My name is Sharon and I am the over 60 crafter. So here's a list of tools required to build this hydroponic tower garden system. A pair of bar clamps, a hacksaw, a jigsaw or hand saw, a tape measure, a Phillips screwdriver or Phillips power bit, a 1 7/8 inch hole saw, and a drill. Here's a list of the materials you would need to build this hydroponic system. 24 feet of 1x3 white pine, 22 feet of 2-inch PVC pipe, 11 2-inch 90 degree elbows, 1 2-inch PVC end cap, 6 2-inch PVC brackets, 2 1/2-inch 90 degree elbows, a small bottle of PVC glue, wood glue and a sheet of sandpaper, a dozen 3/4 inch screws and 2 dozen 1 3/4 inch screws, a submersible pump, 5 feet of 1/2 inch tubing, 2 cable ties, and a food grade 5-gallon bucket with a lid, which you can probably obtain from your local bakery for free. Let's begin by building the stand. We will first need to measure 2 5-foot lengths of the 1x3 for the vertical posts. To hold the posts together, we need 2 horizontal pieces, one at 43 inches for the top and the other at 41.5 inches. For the base, we need 4 18-inch lengths of the 1x3. Go ahead and cut all your pieces using either a jigsaw or a handsaw. To assemble the base pieces, first locate the center of the bottom end of the 2 5-foot posts. Also mark the center of the 4 18-inch pieces. Apply glue, then align the center markings before clamping. Pre-drill 4 holes, then secure the base to the post by inserting 4 1 3/4 inch screws. Continue to attach the remaining 3 base pieces. Measure 36 inches from the top dong of your standing post. Apply glue to the 41.5 inch pieces on both ends. Then attach it to the 36 inch marking on the post. Next, attach the 43 inch piece to the top of the post. Remember to apply glue. Your stand is now ready to be sealed. You can use mineral oil, but since it's difficult to locate here in Trinidad, I decided to apply a shoshugi band finish, after which I applied 2 coats of olive oil. The stand consists of 6 rows of PVC pipe. Let's begin by measuring 5 lengths at 46 inches for the top 5 rows and 30 inches for the bottom row. We would also need to cut 5 pieces at 2.5 inches to join the elbows together. Clamp your pipe to your work table and cut it using a hacksaw. For each of the 46 inch lengths, put markings at 5 inches, 13.5 inches, 22 inches, 31.5 inches, and 40 inches. for a 30 inch length, put markings at 7 inches, 14 inches and 21 inches. After attaching the hole saw to the drill, begin drilling a pilot hole in the first mark. Do not drill straight through, but switch the drill to reverse and drill through the pipe. This way it won't bind and break your pipe. Continue this process until all holes are drilled. Remove the debris by using some sandpaper. Measure 2.5 inches from the end of one of the 46 inch length pieces. Drill a 1/2 inch hole. This is to accommodate your 1/2 inch tubing. Remember to sand the hole smooth. Make an outline of the 2-inch PVC pipe onto the lid of the bucket and cut it out using a jigsaw or utility knife. Cut out a notch on the rim of the bucket to insert the cord for the pump so that the lid sits flat. Attach the first PVC bracket 1/2 inch from the top of the stand, using only a single 3/4 inch screw. Attach the remaining brackets. Check the diagram for their locations. Only screw the top of the bracket as it will be easier to insert the pipe afterwards. With all the PVC brackets in place, we can now begin assembling and gluing the pipes, starting with the 46 inch length in which you drill the 1/2 inch hole. Apply PVC glue before attaching the elbow, then the 2.5 inch PVC spacer, and then the second elbow. You might need to angle the second PVC elbow slightly in order that the 46 inch length can be inserted into the next bracket. Continue gluing the 46 inch pieces, elbows and spacers until you reach the last row. Instead of gluing the PVC fittings, you can also dry fit them, which would make it easier to disassemble and clean between crops. I glued my system because it's not too difficult to clean using a power washer. I, however, dry fitted the last length and used thread seal to avoid any leaks. This makes it easier to relocate the system. Drill a 1/2 inch hole in the bucket's lid. Insert your 1/2 inch tubing into the lid of the bucket and secure it to the post using the cable ties. Connect the 2 1/2 inch elbows to a 1.5 inch piece of tubing. Add another 1.5 inch piece of tubing to the elbow and connect the tubing that comes up from the bucket to the other elbow. Insert the tubing into the hole that you drilled in the pipe. Screw your 1/2 inch adapter into your pump and connect it to your tubing. Once your system is complete, you're ready to add your plants and your hydroponic solution. Please be sure to watch my other hydroponic video, which gives in detail how I mixed this solution and prepared my plants for a 5-gallon system. If you attempt this build, let me know how it turned out in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Catch you later.